Following his summit with this year's G7 host, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, a major announcement from U.S. President Joe Biden.
The United States will purchase a half a billion doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine to donate to nearly 100 nations that are in dire need in the fight against this pandemic.
200 million of these Pfizer vaccines will be delivered by the end of 2021 and 300 million by June of next year. They are in addition to the 80 million already committed by the U.S. to be delivered by the end of the month.
Our vaccine donations don't include pressure for favors or potential concessions. We're doing this to save lives, to end this pandemic.
By announcing his vaccine donation plans on the eve of the G7 summit, a meeting of the world's leading industrial nations, Biden is pushing the group of wealthy countries to follow his lead. He is also rejecting accusations that the U.S. is a vaccine hoarder.
He's trying to signal that America isn't intensely parochial and inward focused, which I think has been a deep concern not only through the Trump years, but quite frankly through the pandemic. When for so long the United States just simply wasn't sharing the vaccine. So I think this is, you know, he's come under pressure globally to do this, to take a leadership role.
Hours after Biden's announcement, Johnson said Britain would give at least 100 million surplus vaccine doses. He expects the G7 to agree to donate a billion doses during the summit, scheduled to begin Friday. Pfizer makes mRNA vaccines, produced not by using weakened forms of the virus, but by using the pathogen's genetic codes.
So far, data show that none of the existing variant strains has escaped the protection provided by our vaccine.
While activists welcome Biden's move, they want wealthy nations to do more to help vaccinate the world, especially those nations that have more doses than they need in the pipeline.
While those doses don't exist today, and of course countries have an obligation to really accelerate the vaccination programs of their domestic populations, they have purchase contracts for more than they need. They need to negotiate now to direct those surplus doses to countries in need. This is the urgent thing that the G7 needs to agree.
The doses will be delivered through COVAX, the United Nations vaccine sharing mechanism. It will cost American taxpayers $3.5 billion, $2 billion of which will be paid with funding already pledged to COVAX. Traveling with the president at the G7 in Cornwall, Patsy Widakuswara, VOA News.